This video tutorial I will explain pagination and get users API call. Here you can see users table and currently it does not have any records. First I will create around 5 users. Then we will see how to get a list of users in a paginated way. Now I am going to create a user. I am going to send this request. And user is successfully created. And here you can see 5 users are created. Here you can see user controller class. And it has a get users method which accept 2 parameters, page and limit. And if page and limit request parameters are missing in the request, then default value for page is 0 and default value for limit is 3. And this method returns a list of user rest objects. And this method produces either XML or JSON. And in this method, what I am doing is I am creating user rest list object. And then I am calling get users method of user service object passing the page and limit, and this method returns user DTO list. Then using for each loop, I am getting each user DTO from user DTO list, and then I am copying user DTO property values to user rest object and adding user rest object to user rest list. Then returns user rest list to the caller. And here you can see interface user service. It has get users method, which is abstract method, and implementation of get users method is there in user service imbl class. And here you can see get users method which accept page and limit. Here I am creating a user DTO list. Then what I am doing is if page value is greater than 0, then minus 1. Then I am calling off method of page request passing page and limit. This method returns pageable object. Then I am calling find all method of user repository object and passing pageable. And this method returns page object. And from page object, I am calling get content method. And it returns list of user entity object. Then using a for each loop, I am getting each user entity object from user entity list. And then what I am doing is, I am copying user entity property values to user DTO object. Then adding user DTO object to user DTO list and returns to the controller. Now I am going to start this application in debug mode. Now I am going to send request to this URL to get JWT token, and email is peter@yahoo.com and password is pass123. Click on send. And we got 200 OK, and click on headers, and here you can see authorization header, and in that I got the JWT token. Copy this. And this is the URL to get list of users. And HTTP method should be get. And add authorization header. And paste the JWT token. Click on send. And request reached here. I did not pass page and limit. So default value is 0. And limit default value is 3. And here we got output, and we got list of 3 users. This is the first user, second user, and third user. And if you notice, we are getting output in XML format. And if you want JSON format, add accept header. And use application/JSON. Click on send. and here we got output in JSON format. Now I will pass page and limit parameters. Page is 0 and limit I will pass as 5. So this request will return 5 records from the database. Click on send. Page value is 0 and limit is 5, which is what I have passed here. And here we got the output. We got 5 records. Now I will change pages 2 and limit as 2. Click on send. And here I got 2 records, Dave and Rom. So we got the records from this position. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.